Hey guys, how's it going? Just getting, trying to get loaded here, still waiting. But I do want to touch on a little something, that, thinking about, when is it time to move, like to get relocated and stuff? And for me, I just think like times that, for instance, I had a delivery in Laredo, when was it, last night, I got delivered in Laredo, and, I seen that there was a lot of traffic there, and a lot of times it will tell you that there's freight moving. But I didn't see nobody moving, and so I was like, it's kind of like, an instinct, what you feel, like, that's just how it is for me. I felt like I would have a better chance, because in my company, there was someone ahead of me, and so I figured if I come to here, to McAllen, that I was going to be the first, only one here, so I figured I had a better chance, and I drove here, I deadheaded like, it's like 2.5 hours, but I sat here, took a nap, and I was here like 4 or 5 hours, and they called me for a load, not even four, it was like 3 or 4 hours, like 3.5 hours, and I woke up from my nap, and I slept for like 1.5 to 2 hours, and ate dinner, and right after dinner, they called me for a load, and so, it just, all depends on where you're at in the country, or where you're at, what state you're in, and so forth, and what your instincts are, I usually go with my gut feeling, man, and my gut feeling was to say, go to McAllen, and so, that's what I did, but the thing is, whatever decision you make, you got to stick with it. If you decide to move, and you move, and you go to that place, stay there. You got to ride it out. There was a time, a couple weeks ago, I was in North Carolina, and I moved 2 hours away, and I was there for 1.5 days waiting, and, ended up getting a load from back where I was originally sitting. And so sometimes it happens like that, but whatever you go with, you got to go with it. Don't go and deadhead somewhere, sit for a day, and then end up moving somewhere else. Cause you're spending all your earnings, you're spending all your money. And so I just think it has a lot to do with what your instincts are, what your gut feeling is. So, all right, man. Well, I'm going to sit here and continue to wait and get loaded. And once I do, I'll get on the road and we will get to Indiana. So, God bless you guys. Finally got loaded here in Texas. Got here at 8 o'clock. Pickup was at 9. That's Eastern. And it is 1 o'clock. It is Tuesday. Tuesday night. Well, it's Wednesday morning, 1 o'clock, but it don't deliver until Thursday night at 11 p.m. So I got plenty of time. It's going about 1,300 miles or so. 18-hour drive. So let me get on down the road and we'll catch y'all on the flip side, guys. God bless you guys and be safe out there. y'all doing this morning? I just getting up, getting ready to get going. It's 8 o'clock Eastern. I'm still in Texas. I got picked up late last night, and I was sitting there for 4 or 5 hours, so I was pretty tired. And I got all kinds of time to get to my drop. But that doesn't necessarily mean that you should take your time when you got extra time. You know, I'm still gonna try to get there early Thursday. It don't drop till 11 o'clock. It's not supposed to drop until, you know, I got until 11 o'clock Thursday night, but I'm really gonna try to get it there Thursday, early Thursday, so hopefully we can get another load out of Indiana somewhere. But yeah, man, I'm gonna get going here. I only drove like probably an hour and a half after my pickup, but I was so tired I just pulled over at this little rest area and crashed out for a couple hours. I slept for maybe 4.5 hours. I'm ready to hit it though, get on the road and get me a good 12-13 hour day in. But anyhow, man, just wanted to tell you about repositioning yourself, man. That's what I did yesterday. I delivered in Laredo, and I just wasn't feeling it. I just wasn't feeling Laredo this time, and I seen a lot, man. I seen so many expediters down there, man. I was like, you know, it was oversaturated. It was packed. And I was like, and that don't necessarily really mean anything. It's just, I just wasn't feeling it. And I was like, so, and there was already a person in front of me within my company. So I was like, well, let me check other areas. And I was thinking about Dallas, you know, but then a couple of people said McAllen, and I called my dispatch, and that's what they said. So, hey, I went down to McAllen and sat for a couple hours. I thought it was late at night, and, you know, it was like 7:30, 8 o'clock, and they don't usually, I don't think I've ever got called that late to drive all night. I mean, I've gotten called that late to pick up next morning, but, yeah, so I got loaded, man, and I got that load out of McAllen, man, and so it's gonna work out pretty good for me. So, yeah, man, let me get on this road, man, and get to Indiana and see what we can come up with, man. Just follow me on this journey today, man. God bless you guys. Y'all be safe out there, man. Take care.
Sleeping up and doing it again. So
I've been driving for about an hour now, trying to get through Arkansas, trying to get to Indiana. And so, just wanted to touch on, you know, relocating. You know, when should you relocate? To me personally, like I said before, it's a gut feeling. Part of it is, for another, if you, you know, whatever company you're with, if there's one, two, if there's two or more people in front of you, I would go ahead and relocate. Like I said, it all depends on where you're at, you know, what state you're in and stuff. Like, if you're down in Laredo, I mean, it's a hard decision when you're down in Laredo, because you don't know, because it, sometimes you can get out of there, sometimes you sit for 3 or 4 days. Then again, also what matters, a lot of companies don't want you moving, like, you know, the big companies, you know, Bolt Express, Panther, you know, those type, them big companies, they would just rather you sit there and wait for a load. From my experience, I don't know about too much about Panther, but I know when I worked for Bolt, I was down in Laredo for 5.5 days waiting for a load, but they didn't want me to relocate. They wanted me to stay right where I was at. So, relocating. So my thought process was, you know, staying communicated with your dispatch. Your dispatch tells you, yeah, go ahead and move, and you know, probably they know where the freight is, where the freight's moving to. So, you know, yeah, for the most part, listen to your dispatch. Now, sometimes it's better to just sit and wait it out. You know, like I said, if whatever decision you make, stick with it. You know. And if you happen to move, stay where you're at. Don't move again. So, yeah, man, that's my take on relocating. One thing about this business I'm learning is that you gotta have patience dealing with this. Because me, someone like me that don't have patience at all, I'm ready to move, you know. So I'm ready to go. If I'm rested up and everything, and of course, if I've been driving all day and I need a couple hours of sleep, you know, of course. But once I get up, I'm ready to go. And that's one thing I hate when I get unloaded and give me some sleep and. Wake up and I'm sitting for a day or two, it drives me insane, and I'm just like, all right, we're ready to go. You know what I'm saying? And so, you know, relocating, man, you got to be patient, man. You got to be patient. A lot of times I'll get somewhere and I'm sitting for a couple hours and I'm just like, man, should I move? Should I, you know, just got to have patience for one. Yeah, it all comes down to where you're at, what part of the country you're in. You know, a lot of stuff out west. I mean, I ain't been out there yet, but from what people have told me, you know, usually when you go out west, you're gonna want to deadhead back. There's hardly any freight out west, so you're gonna want to deadhead back to like towards Texas. So that's my take on relocating, y'all. Make sure you know you get the right sleep you need. And don't let people discourage you about, you know, running, you know. Yeah, there's times companies are gonna want you to drive straight 16 hours, and you have to do that sometimes. But other times, man, you gotta make sure you're rested for the next load, you know. Like me, I'm on this load and I'm running. I ran all day. I drove probably 12 hours altogether, you know. But instead of me getting there, you know, instead of me getting there and getting unloaded at 4 in the morning, 4 or 5 in the morning, and sleeping till noon, I pulled over and I slept for 4 and a half hours. And I'll get there the same amount of time as I would as if I got there and got some sleep, you know. So now when I get there, I don't have to sleep. When I get there, I unload and hopefully get another load and be ready to go, you know. You gotta make sure you get enough sleep, man, you know. I know that's off the subject, but I just thought I'd put it out there, you know. So, all right, man, I'm gonna quit rambling and get off of here and get to Indiana and get this unloaded and hopefully get something out of Indiana. So, all right, y'all, man, y'all have a blessed day. Y'all be safe out there, man.
In 800 feet, turn left onto County Road 525 South. Take the next left onto County Road 525 South, then you will arrive at your destination.
Turn left here and it says I'll reach my destination.
You have arrived.
I have arrived. Let's see where we're at, guys. Do you see any buildings anywhere near? You have arrived. Alrighty then. Well, according to GPS or maps, I put in the name of the company and it says it's 10 minutes away, but the address they gave me was no good apparently. So let's go to this address and see where it takes me, guys. Well, it says I'm half a mile from the place after I put the address in, so let's see if we can pull up there, guys. Well, this is more like it, guys. I believe we have found our spot. So, well, guys, apparently this ain't it. So they gave me another address. We're going to go check it out. That's 8 minutes away from here. So follow me there, guys. Alright, there it is, guys. I got unloaded. Finally found the right place. And, you know what I mean? Here in Indiana, it is 1:15 Eastern, 12:15 Central. I'm still, this Indiana, part of Indiana, I'm still Central Time, so it's still only 12:15 here. So we will try to get a load out of here today, hopefully. So, yeah, man. If you have not subscribed to my channel, go ahead and subscribe. I thank you for the ones that have done subscribe. Keep following me. Got much more ahead of me. You know, give me your thoughts on what you think about relocating, because that's what I was talking about, you know, trying to relocate. And like I said, for me, it's just, you know, a gut feeling. And also depending on what city you live in or what city you're in. Like right now, I'm in Indiana. I'm over by, I believe it's west of Indianapolis, about an hour and a half out of Indianapolis. In the Terre Haute area, Evansville area, that area. So we'll see what happens. But until the next video, man, God bless you guys, and y'all be safe out there, man.